Pod for Wednesday, and this was the product review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
You interrupted Wayne this week.
He took over me last month.
Right, first of all, we've got it. It's actually arrived in
He's
the country.
Got it.
He's
got it on.
The VAPR watch is here. Look at that beauty.
Look at it.
Right, so first impressions, guys, because literally this is an out-of-the-box review.
We've literally just turned up,
opened it.
We've watched the download, we know what we're doing, but we haven't had time to charge it up or get it all ready or anything like that. But we wanted to show you what it looks like on the wrist, so there's a nice close-up for you. What do you reckon to the look of the watch, Sean?
Well, number one, it's a functional watch.
It is a functional watch.
You can tell the time.
Let me just show you this, actually. This is unbelievable. Apparently, Sansminds went to Seiko.
Yeah,
and
had
their own design of watch made. And this is absolutely incredible. Just this bit, just here, is the functioning part of the watch.
Yeah.
That is absolutely amazing.
So that is a watch on its own.
And if you look just here, that is the workings to the watch. This pulls out and that's how you adjust it. And just that alone is the working part of the watch. I actually really like this design around the outside. This steel sort of
cool. I quite like it. It looks a little bit steampunky. I really like it.
Yeah, they'd sell that in a fashionable shop.
It really does look cool. If you're performing in a casual setting, somebody could look at that and it actually does look like a real nice watch.
Even the sneaky bits look incredibly well made. This looks like a product that's been actually put together properly rather than something that's been made in somebody's shed with a soldering iron.
Definitely. They spent time on it.
This is a proper product. This is good.
Will says on the download that there's, I think it's 180 original parts that were designed for this. Now, we can't go mentioning this review without talking about the Lynx Magic watch, and both of them were in development at the same time, and Lynx got theirs out first. In comparison, do you think this is superior?
Well, I think the Lynx thing was something that maybe was a prototype. Yeah. So at the stage before something got to this, you could kind of take it to a designer and go, here's my rough bits and bones idea. This is an actual finished product. It looks professional. It looks professional from the outside. It's functional. You're not going to burn your wrist on it. You're not going to have a hissy, spitty noise from it.
I always meant, like, it did have a bit of charging when we got it before. We haven't got time to charge it up. We pressed the remote and we got it. And the amount of smoke
was incredible.
The amount of
smoke. That just shocked me how much smoke you got out of
it. You really didn't expect any smoke. And it works with a pump. And when you set your strap up, the smoke comes out from just the right position, and this is fully adjustable. I'll take this off in a moment. And even the strap has been thought about. I think with the Lynx Magic version, it was kind of like they'd got an existing strap and then they just glued bits onto it with Velcro. This has been custom made,
yeah,
so
that's
you
been
can
molded
adjust
like
it
that.
Well, what made
to
the
any size.
What made the Lynx one unusable for me was that sneaky bit where the smoke came out of wouldn't necessarily always stay underneath the strap for me. And so I'd go to use it and be like, oh, I can't do it now because it's kind of hanging out.
Well,
whereas with this, you've not got a danger of that happening. It's all been designed into the watch, so that doesn't happen.
After we reviewed the Lynx Magic one, I went out and used it a couple of times and I burnt myself.
You did. You burnt yourself.
Because it works with like a heated coil, that one, which isn't as superior as this. But when you bend, the flap of skin goes inside the coil, and this flap of skin here can touch the coil and just literally burn you, and I burnt myself here.
It's also a lot quieter, this.
Yeah, it makes a sound like when you're in a silent room, it kind of just like a very quiet whoosh.
Well, I tell you what, here's something. I would be
like
confident.
You're not going to hear that.
You wouldn't hear it again. No chance.
From a noise point of view, I would use the Lynx watch in a restaurant or a gig environment, but I'd be sceptical about using it when all the focus was on in a parlour show. If I was close to them, I'd be sceptical of the noise. If it was silent at that point.
It's a lot noisier.
But
so this is quieter.
With this, I could use this in my parlour show. I could build up all the tension and actually have it happen at that point.
So you can see on the underside there, I've set it up ready to charge with the tube here.
Very well.
And you get
made.
These extra bits, which shows me as well that they're constantly thinking about it, because when they first recorded the download, they were saying about fixing this in place with a bit of tape. And now they've got these extra bits that they've supplied, which lock it in into the strap, holding the tube in exactly the right position. And you can adjust this in any way you like. Yeah. And you can also adjust it to the left or to the right. Mm. So you can have the smoke going this way as well.
Yeah.
And when he does the ash on arm...
It's incredible.
That is an unbelievable effect now.
It is an unbelievable effect. But here's the... You said, oh, it's too much setup for me, for like possible for it to be talking about. But the
I'm not bothered about the ice.
I am going to... That's worth me buying the watch. Because there's certain moments when I'm performing that I don't mind going a little bit extra than what I know the magician down the road is going to go for me. So I can create that moment, pour a little bit of water in, then all the steam... And then I open up and there's a bit of ice with the corner of their card in it.
Well, Will demonstrates with putting the corner in and then the ice cube, it freezes
with
the ice cube.
Well, no, you pour water in and the water freezes and then...
Amazing. Great. I think for a TV or something, I think it's beautiful, but I wouldn't do it in a gigging situation. The ash on arm I'd actually do.
Yeah.
If you pre-showed somebody and you got their initials or something like that or a
that
card,
would be brilliant.
And
yeah.
Then the way the smoke looks as you're doing this, it is absolutely unbelievable. And it turns that effect into something that's going to make people gasp.
If you're doing tables, right, and you're being booked to do the drinks afterwards, which sometimes happens at weddings now, you do like the tables either an hour afterwards at the bar, right? Now, if you could remember a couple of names that you haven't spoken to, even maybe not even been to their table, but you've looked at the place names, and then you've got their name on your arm or something.
Yeah, you're going to knock them out.
You're doing
you
your ambitious card and you go, shh. The steam comes, you give it all that.
I haven't opened my refills yet and tried to charge it, but it comes with a Bluetooth remote, a wrist strap as well. So the wrist strap can hide
so
that remote
well made,
on you.
So
you
well
said about
together.
Putting it in your toe. You used to do that with the VAPR, didn't
you? Yeah, and with another trick that I used to do, I've forgotten what it was, but something else I used a toe switch. But instead of having it, well, people think you have to have your toe switch underneath your toe. That's not where a toe switch goes. A toe switch actually goes on the top of your toes. So you strap it with a bandage on top of your toes, and then you activate it by lifting your toes upwards. Because then you've got no danger of activating it. But a lot of people think you put it underneath your toe, but a toe switch goes on top of your toe, and you lift upwards.
Good point.
It charges here. This is where it gets refilled. And you just take that bit off there, swing it over to the other side, and you refill it here through this little hole. And when it's refilled... It's good for over 100 puffs of smoke. So you could easily use it all day on even a trade show stand.
Yeah.
I know with the, going back to the other one, after 3 or 4 times you were there in the corner and you were having to refill it again. So the charge lasts more than a day and the remote lasts like literally forever. I know that from having the original VAPR as well. But the charge will last easily a full day with the watch and the smokes. You've got over 100 puffs in there. And I keep saying about that, even though they've got this micro pump in there, which is amazingly new technology that's going to be used in the medical industry, the thing that I can't get over is this watch, the fact that it's so thin. It's a working watch, and when that locks on there, you've actually got a working watch, and yet in something which is so incredibly thin and doesn't look too out of place on your arm at all, you've got a smoke machine.
It's brilliant.
It's unbelievable. It is the best out there. They've really thought about it. They've not rushed it out. The quality is very, very good.
Brilliantly made.
Not everything's brilliant that comes out from Sansminds, as we've said before, but, you know, when they bring out a good one,
well, you know, when
they
when it's in a white box like that, you're not going to be disappointed.
It's fantastic. It's fantastic quality. I can't wait to use it more and more. We're not going to mark it because it's not available from us. It's just from Sansminds Magic. I think they're trying to recoup a massive investment that they've put into this. And it's not surprising because it's all there in the product. So well done. Great work.
Yeah.
And next up, we've got Whiplash by Joshua Januski.
I love this.
Wayne's favourite trick of the week.
So Wayne, it is. I know there's been gimmicks like this out before.
Not the same as this, though.
Not the same, no. Not the same. Things like Slither by Eric Jones. I think Jordan Victoria had something that did something similar, but this is different, isn't it?
This is different. This is different. The gimmick for this, it enables you to vanish a card, make a card appear, or even face down and face up. That's the bit, face down and face up.
And the gimmick comes with, it's like a custom, we'll not show you what the gimmick does, because that's for you if you get the download, it comes with downloadable instructions that I nearly showed
you just had to hide
on the close-up camera.
Then.
But the gimmick, I'll not show you what the gimmick does, but this is the gimmick. It looks like a normal card. It's not got rider. It's not a rider back, is it?
No one's going to notice that.
But this isn't a card that the spectators are going to be handling. Yeah. This is just for you to be handling, so nobody's going to notice that slight difference between the rider back and a genuine back.
Best bit in it.
Right, what's your favourite bit?
The face-up oil and water. You know the oil and water effect where the red cards are interlaced with the black cards and then they separate? That happens face down normally. This happens face up. It is brilliant. It's up on there, holds the cards, red, black, red, black, red, black, and literally this. And I don't like none of that waving nonsense. I don't like
12
that.
Chains.
I don't like that. When you're shaking your hand about anything can happen, this you can hold. What do you mean?
I'm going to show something Wayne afterwards and he's going to change his mind.
I'm not going to change my mind.
You're going to change your mind.
What's happening? I don't know because you're shaking your hand about.
I tell you what, if you're shaking your hand like that, you're doing it wrong. It should be a little...
Alright, okay.
Then it looks good.
Okay.
Well, what happens with this? You don't have to shake your hands at all. You can literally hold it there and it bang and it just changes on that lovely offbeat moment when you're looking at them and you look back down, pop. And there it is.
Shouldn't they be
really
watching it while it happens?
Yeah, you can, but I love that offbeat moment of catching their eyes and as they look down, take advantage of that moment where their eyes refocus and it changes then. It's a beautiful moment.
But surely you could do that with, like, to say, a shaky change, if you're doing a shift to the gaze.
Yeah, if you want to wave your arms about all over the place.
Well, you don't have to if you're doing it with them and their gaze
you
is
don't,
up here.
No.
I think
hold
what's
it there
great,
and it changes right there.
That's what I'm
hands.
Saying. I think you just said that wasn't you, so you do it live there. I think what's great about Whiplash is when their eyes are actually burning it, bam! That's when it changes. When they're burning it, it can happen.
It can do, yeah. And it can do brilliantly, because you don't have to shake it about.
Shake what about?
Anything. Like, what's going on? Oh, magic. I'm doing magic by shaking it.
You know the effect that's kind of like that thing Blaine made into a classic with the two cards, where they're holding two cards.
Two-card Monty.
I like that. I do like, but only one of the cards apparently changes, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So it's slightly less in effect, but you get that visual moment of the change in the hands. I think that's really good.
Yeah, that's great.
There's so many ideas on this, and what's great to see is Joshua is passionate about his hairballs. Joshua is passionate about this project. It's very, very well shot. He's put a lot of thought into the routines. He hasn't just come up with a gimmick and sort of put it out there straight away. You can tell that he's been out, he's used every single one of these
routines.
That's
the bit, you can tell he's actually been out and worked it, and I love that.
And you can see some great live performances on the download. If you buy this, you are not going to be disappointed. Mm. It's not for me, because I think I can do similar things using sleight of hand, like the two-card Monty that get...
Without shaking it.
Almost, I don't need to shake it about, but...
You can do the changes without shaking it as well. I can do the changes without shaking it. Well.
When you are holding it like this in your fingers, and they're staring at it and it changes, it looks sublime. It's beautiful.
I know you love this, Wayne, and you've already said you're going to go out and try this and use it, so we expect a video very soon, just like the Paradox puzzle.
Yeah, yes.
How much are you going to get it?
You know what? I'm actually going to give this 96.
Whoa! 96!
I like it. I love it.
Oh.
Brilliant piece of magic.
And it's 24 from me. No, I'm joking. It's a lot better than that. I'm going to give this 83%.
I'm not quite going up there with 83%. It's going to be in the 70s, 79% from me.
Yeah, it's
I think
great.
That's fair.
Joshua, I look forward to seeing more from Joshua as well, because he's a great young creator. He's got a great mind, very passionate about his project, and a great performer as well to see these effects working in the real world. Good project.
That's why it's worth 96.
And next up, we've got...
Conscious Magic.
Tonka's Magic 2. It's got a previous worker of the week, this effect. I say effect, more like a project, hasn't it?
Yeah, yeah, definitely, yeah.
Four effects on there, Andrew Gerard and Ran Pink. Take us through a masterclass in mentalism. And it is very, very good, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's our overall thoughts, but let's talk about the effects that are on there. First of all, we've got Get Lucky, which was...
a lottery prediction, which I thought, you know what? I don't normally do prediction-y type effects, but I really like this. I really loved it. So I'll synopsisize it, and then we can Wayne can tell us what he thinks, then we can tell him that he's wrong. So what happens is, you get some lottery tickets, you show them they're all blank.
Do you have to shake them?
You'd have to shake them.
Stop that now.
And then you turn the lottery tickets upside down, so the numbers are pointing towards the floor.
Yeah.
A person takes a pen, they mark a few of the tickets.
Is the pen working?
The pen is a working pen. It's not that way that you think with a pen that doesn't work. They could check it. The pen works. You turn them back up. You give them their ticket that they've marked. You put the other tickets away, whatever. You then tell them what numbers that they marked.
Yeah.
Okay. And not only that, you then open up your wallet, and inside your wallet, you've got a lottery ticket that you actually bought, and printed on that are the numbers that they actually chose for that lottery ticket. So it's kind of like a two-stage mentalism routine. What I like about this is it is kind of impromptu. So in a way that if I was at a coffee shop and I really wanted to do some mentalism, I could go to the news agents next door and get everything that I needed in under 2 or 3 minutes to go back and show some people this effect.
Okay, Wayne, what did you think about it?
This is the least effective.
I agree with you. I didn't like it as much, the lottery prediction.
I don't
think
like
it's a long, convoluted way to do the lottery prediction, but here's where we disagree. You don't like lottery predictions.
I don't like lottery
predictions. Why do you not like lottery predictions?
Because I have too many people say to me afterwards, "Are you really predicting the lottery? That's amazing, that's clever. Why aren't you driving
Here's where you're wrong. Because most people that do a lottery prediction, I'll answer because I actually do it in my
show. I've got a question after you. Go on, you ask
the question.
He'll come up with some constructive
You know what I'm going to say. I went to watch you in a show and you turned a blank bit of paper into a £10 note. You did it, so by
how
that
inconsiderate.
Shouldn't you be at home doing that all day long and driving around in a Bentley?
Can I answer the question? It was a tenner. Not millions.
Yeah, but £10.
It was a £10 note.
All day long.
What's it supposed to look like? You could magically change paper into a tenner, though.
Yes.
Yeah, tenner.
Yeah.
But
you could do that.
I haven't just won the lottery.
Why don't you go to Staples, buy shed loads of paper, and just make loads of £10 notes all day long?
I'll tell you where you got it wrong. Stop banging the table.
Okay.
Right. So why I disagree is with the lottery prediction thing, and where I think you're wrong is most people actually, if they haven't highlighted this in their routine with a lottery prediction, they should do. I think most people have their routine structured in a certain way that they highlight that they're using a lottery ticket, a physical thing, as proof, a permanent piece of proof, because a lottery ticket is, it's there, it's permanent, it's a piece of proof, for what numbers people would choose. And you're actually predicting the choices of human beings and not actually predicting. Yeah. And I actually say during my presentation, you can't actually predict the lottery because you can't manipulate the machine because the balls will bounce all the time in different directions. Mm-hmm. But you can actually...
People can manipulate people using
psychology.
And here's proof. This ticket's dated 3 weeks ago. Blah, blah, blah.
Exactly, okay. And the ticket the ticket is just your permanence and your proof for showing that you can manipulate people. Anyway, next effect on there was just getting the right name. We now to kind of describe the effects becoming probably a lesson in magic for everybody. I really love this.
An ambitious card,
but not continually jumping to the top
of the day. A one stage ambitious card, not a 33 stage ambitious card. A one stage ambitious card routine. Done in a slightly different way to what the standard way of doing an ambitious card routine is.
I learnt a lot from Andrew's psychology with this. Just the idea of one card, but making it totally about the spectator.
Yeah.
And I think if you're in this situation, and you made the point earlier, Sean, that this isn't really material for a gig, is it?
Mm. No, this is material. If you really want to impress one person, maybe that really pretty girl at the bar, you know, you're that age, you're at bars, and you want to make it all about
that age,
them.
That age?
That age. You know. What does that mean?
Well, you know, that age where you need to impress them.
What, it gets
them.
To a certain that age where you have to stop?
No, that age where you need to impress them. Now they're just generally impressed and they're flocking around you, aren't they?
That's what you meant.
That's what you're meant. So it's, you're making it all about them. There's hundreds of people in this bar. There's all these cards in the pack. One card's got your name on it. One card is you, and you need to be standing out more than everybody else, blah, 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 and rise to the top. And make it all about them, and then that card does rise to the top. They rise to the top, and they feel great.
You can tell Andrew's thinking about it in this way as well, because he does this rather seedy thing, which harks back to the Chris Randall review days of the Wizard Product Review.
Where the biscuit!
Chris Randall, where he did this thing where he said, you know, but I'll show you the best penetration you've ever seen. This DVD was awful. It's one of the worst DVDs I've ever seen. But Andrew did this thing where he's saying, you know, let's do the biscuit thing. And he wanted to put the biscuit in his mouth and bite it with her at the end. And she's like no. The card trick was all right, buddy, but we'll leave it just there. Right, radio. What was radio?
Radio was a mentalism effect where...
It's based on, like, Turvill sort of billet techniques and that kind of thing. You could learn a lot from this.
You were predicting... What was so funny about it? Something really funny. Madonna... Where she was basically thinking of a musician or a song or whatever, and he started singing to her, like, this song really means a lot to you.
Yeah, he said, this song means a lot to you.
This reminds
like
of you,
virgin.
This artist, this is all about you, this is just it. Like a virgin.
And she was all right with it. First time. I think she was kind of
She did look a bit like Madonna in the good days, but before all the muscle and that, didn't she?
But again, you know, some great techniques. The strength of this project is never about the tricks these guys do. It's when they're back in the studio and they talk about their thought process around it.
Well, what's really nice about this one specifically, about halfway through, there's a bit where the structure and the way the spectators are actually really going to forget everything that went on. And at the end, she's going to be going, I had that piece of paper in my hand the whole time.
And it's the way they structure that.
Yeah, and that's
Let's talk about this last effect very, very briefly. Mm. It's called 50-50, a great effect that you can do anytime. When you predict quite clearly and very fairly, you put a banknote on the table, like a £50 note or a $100 bill, and you predict which hand the spectator will pick it up with. Very clever psychology involved. It's going to work. It's going to work under any conditions.
Well, what's really clever, we watched this and we're going, oh, it's that, is this? And we were wrong. And it's like, no, it's not. Mm. And then at the end of it, it's like, oh my God, that is brilliant.
They're really doing it.
And what's really clever is those two pictures, the what's really happened, the prediction, it's like and they match exactly, the
Perfectly.
Pictures match at the end, and that's what's
and
wired
when Sean's referring
minds.
To pictures, it seems like we're getting deeper and deeper into this effect. I just wanted to touch on it very briefly, because we're getting towards the end of the show. You kind of write left and right, and at the end you've circled ones, and you put a mark next to the one they choose, and it ends up being the hand. We'll put clips on the screen, it should explain it a little bit more, because we're a little bit short on time. How much are you going to give it?
91.
I'm going to do something from it, I think.
I'm going to give it 93% this one. I really like the left and right hand. It's made me really think about the importance of our spectators when doing something like the ambitious card and how you can present your magic in a way and make everything really important and really relevant for your spectators. That's what that discussion set me thinking about, and it's really, really inspired me. As did the original Conscious Magic 1. If you haven't got that, you should check it out. Best out of this world out there, in my opinion. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Blackpool is getting closer and closer. Until then, we'll see you next time. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
Please asleep.
See you next time on the Wizard Product Review.